Hello, and welcome back to my YouTube channel on this amazing Friday. Today I am coming to you from in between my wardrobe and my bed, and I do not understand why I decided that this space is very beautiful for me to shoot a video from, but I've never shot a video from here, so it kind of looks good. Anywho, on to serious matters. Welcome back to my YouTube channel and this amazing day. If you are a new person here, I want to welcome you to my YouTube channel. My name is Doreen Mora Moracha. I call myself the undetectable queen, the amazing host to a very tiny guest called HIV, which I've lived with my whole life. And I'm bringing to you another educational video about matters HIV. In fact, this is probably, as I told you guys some time back, if I ever did like a frequently asked question thing, this shows up on my frequently asked questions in my different social media timelines. So if you're new here, I want to tell you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Come back again next week on Friday. Go back and watch some of the videos that might interest you. If you're the oldies, the people who we have been together, and you are watching this video and you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, tell yourself, shame on you. How can you keep coming back and you're not subscribing? But you can also give this video a like. You can comment, leave a beautiful comment on the comment section, and I will definitely be very happy, okay? Today I want us to talk about kissing and HIV. Does kissing transmit HIV? So up until this particular moment, because I've not answered you, I want you to answer me in the comment section. Does kissing actually transmit HIV? Do you believe it transmits HIV? And if yes, why? If no, why? Right? So let's get straight into the video. You cannot catch HIV from kissing. Or you cannot get HIV through kissing, or you cannot transmit HIV through kissing. So in short, the answer is no. Kissing does not transmit HIV. HIV is a virus that is transmitted through body fluids, and those body fluids are blood, semen, and vaginal fluids, but not saliva. So you might be asking yourself, but saliva is a body fluid. Why exactly is saliva not a way, or rather a method of HIV transmission? It's because the amount of HIV antibodies in saliva are so little that they cannot transmit HIV from person A to person B. And when you are undetectable, if you do not know what undetectable is, being undetectable means that you have taken a person living with HIV who has been taking their ARVs correctly and consistently is able to now reduce the level of virus in their body, and through that they cannot transmit HIV to a negative person sexually. You know that you're virally suppressed, or rather you're undetectable, by getting a test called a viral load test that is done after every 6 months or once a year. It depends with the facility you go to. So what I'm trying to say is the level of the level of antibodies of HIV in saliva are so little. So if you have HIV and you want to make out with your partner, you want to kiss your partner, please feel free to do that. Why I'm telling you that is because you require at least 70,000 liters of saliva. I don't think that is humanly possible. Like, to be honest, that is not humanly possible to actually have... this Dera is beautiful. Okay, focus. So you require at least 70,000 liters of saliva in order to transmit HIV from person one to person two. And we all know that that is not a very practical number, right? And some of you may ask, but if through deep kissing... Yeah, I've gotten this comment that through deep kissing, people living with HIV can actually transmit HIV, can transmit HIV through kissing. But exactly what is deep kissing, guys? I know there is the peck, right? The one on, there is this kissing where you kiss here. There is the one that men kiss you here, and then immediately all your sense is gone, and now you start buying them things that they do not need. And, but if you mean like a French kiss, still it cannot transmit HIV. A lot of people are very scared of even kissing their partners just because they feel like if I kiss my partner, I am not going to, they're going to get infected, but actually they're not. So some people say that if you kiss someone with sauce, you might get HIV. I tend to disagree. Also, why are you kissing people with sauce? I don't get it. What kind of fetish is this? Like, I have had so many fetishes, but which fetish is this that requires you to kiss somebody with sauce in their mouth? This is where Nigerians say is omo, because why are you kissing people with sauce that you can see? So anyway, there's something that happened to me a lot of years back, actually, not even a few, because it's been more than 10 years since it happened. I used to have a male best friend. So one time, and now I actually understand why my boyfriend never liked my male friends. Okay, so one time, the bestie thing, and we kind of just kissed. So when we were kissing, it just became a little bit weird. And so I was like, no, we can't do this. Like, there are people who are in my life and I want them in my life as friends forever. Nothing more, nothing less. That's it. So I was like, this path that you are going, little girl, this path that you are taking yourself is a very dangerous path. Oh, so I stopped that path. But now, after we kissed, the following day he woke up with cold sores. I don't know whether you know what cold sores are. They're those sores that, those two things you get on outside your lips when you have like a low immunity, you have a cold, or rather something triggered them in you, right? For people living with HIV, because our immunity is already compromised, we tend to get them a little bit more often. So I did not have cold sores at that point, and I do not know how he ended up with cold sores. But he actually accused me of infecting him. Do you know, he even told me, is it because I kissed you that now I have cold sores? Since then, I actually got a little bit of PTSD in kissing people, because I'm like, is it me? Am I the drama? Did I? But no, I did not, because I was on my treatment and I don't know whether I was virally suppressed, because viral suppression started, the U equals U campaign started in 2018, but I was on treatment that time. So I don't know why it happened like that, but it happened. It doesn't mean that cold sores are for HIV positive people, only they also occur in HIV negative people. So it kind of gave me the chills, like, yeah. But anyway, that is the only case that has ever happened. Otherwise, I love kissing a lot, so it is what it is. So kissing does not transmit HIV. But it can transmit other things, such as there's an hepatitis, there's the cold sores, there is the herpes. There's a type of herpes that is also transmitted through kissing. So also don't go about kissing everybody. You know the way they say that you have to kiss very many frogs before you meet Prince Charming. Please reduce the number of frogs that you are kissing, because you might kiss a frog that has hepatitis and then they infect you, and then now you are over here telling me, Doreen, I kissed a person. Do I have HIV? No. HIV ideally is not spread through kissing at any point, whether it is deep kiss, whether it is small kiss, whether it is tiny kiss. It is not transmitted in any way using, it is not a way of HIV transmission. Some people will ask me, or rather some people have asked me, if kissing does not transmit HIV, why is it that when we do the oral quick test, we pass it through our, this part. What is the name? This name always leaves me. Yeah, this part. I know the Swahili word is called ufizi. The English word is kind of running away from me at this point. So the thing is, you are not putting the test in your saliva. You are putting it here, right outside the teeth here, and up here. So there is no way, when I say here, it's not like on the top, like it's inside. Yeah. So you are not putting it there. It's ideally not in the mouth where we got a lot of saliva. It is literally out here, which means what it's actually just trying to pick is the antibodies, is to test for the antibodies. and the antibodies are present. I have not said that the antibodies of HIV are absent. They are very much present in saliva. However, they do not transmit HIV. They don't have the strength. They don't have the power to transmit HIV from person one to person two. And some of you can even say that, but if I am undetectable, then it means that I can kiss my partner whatever time. But even if you're detectable, you have not yet reached the point of suppressing your viral load, you still cannot transmit HIV through kissing, okay? So that is just what I want to make it very clear in this video. But however, I want to go through some of the ways that you can actually get HIV, the practical ways. So the most common way HIV is spread, of course, is through sexual intercourse, by sexual intercourse with a person who is HIV positive, not virally suppressed, and not on treatment. So those are the two people. If they might be on treatment but not virally suppressed, they might have not yet started treatment. So those can actually put you at the risk, or rather at risk's way of getting HIV. We also have oral sex and anal sex. So oral sex has a chance. The other time somebody asked me recently, I don't know whether it was on my Instagram or my Facebook, but somebody sent me a message and asked me if going down on your partner can actually give you HIV. There is a small chance. There is a small possibility. So with it, you can't rule a no. It is more of a maybe. It is a very gray area, but it can put you at risk of getting infected with HIV, especially if your partner's private parts have sores. So yeah, so the HIV virus can also be spread by sharing of sharp objects with the person who is infected. They can also be, HIV can also be passed on from what you call vertical transmission of HIV, that is from the mother to the child. And also what you can do in this case, ensure that the other person is virally suppressed and on treatment. Your HIV positive partner is suppressed, virally suppressed and on treatment. And if they are not, you can, as a partner, if it already happened, you can go and get post-exposure prophylaxis, which is medication taken within 72 hours after HIV exposure, or you can take PrEP, pre-exposure prophylaxis, which is medication taken 7 days before having sex with a positive partner and for as long as you are at risk of getting HIV. For mothers, to prevent vertical transmission, start your antenatal clinic early, start your ARVs early, ensure that you are virally suppressed as well. But you cannot get HIV by shaking hands, sharing of utensils. You can also not get HIV by giving mouth-to-mouth, the resuscitation. You cannot get HIV through that. You also cannot get HIV by sharing swimming pools. You cannot get HIV by sharing toilet seats and all that. And you cannot get HIV by sharing towels, bathrooms, all of those. You cannot get HIV through those. And you cannot get HIV. I saw a video the other day on Instagram that there are people who believe that they cannot eat food cooked by a HIV positive person because they believe that they might get infected. So those are not ways of getting HIV, getting infected with HIV. So I want us to reduce new HIV infections. That is the goal for 2022. And so far, we are not doing so well. So please continue preventing yourself. Use condoms, use PrEP, use PEP. And if you are HIV positive, ensure that you are undetectable so that you do not transmit HIV to any other person. We are beautiful stories. We are greater than HIV. And up to this particular moment, we have now concluded that kissing does not transmit HIV. So subscribe to my channel, leave a comment, like, and share this video. And let me see you next week. Bye-bye.